two ladies that are actually feeding the world by feeding our society better. Please welcome on stage with me the women from Lolos.
You're rocking with the best, dat weet je best, yes, yes. We schieten in de roos, niet in de stress, yes, yes. We lopen in de pas, niet in de mes. Bij de tijd, bij de pinken, bij de handen, bij de les, yes, yes. You're rocking with the best, dat weet je best, yes, yes. We schieten in de roos, niet in de stress, yes, yes. We lopen in de pas, niet in het mes. Bij de tijd, bij de pinken, bij de handen, bij de les, yes, yes.
Hi. Not only the judges, hè? There are more people here.
Oh, awesome. Huh? So I see there's some wonderful young ladies sharing out goodies. I actually didn't step outside during the break, so I'm quite hungry as well. But please, I'm intrigued. Tell us more.
Well, what do you want to know?
Well, what exactly are these wonderful young ladies doing?
Well, these are two of the main parts of our company, because we co-create with children. And they are our board of advisors, part of our board of advisors. And so they came here to actually give you the product that Lisanne will tell you all about.
Wonderful. Thank you. Yeah.
So you're going to talk to us tonight.
Yes, I'm going to tell you all about Lolos and about the great snacks we developed.
Okay, perfect. Because I know I'm a bit of a passion, purpose kind of guy, but what are you guys going for? What's the end goal?
We go for profit first and then our purpose, because without profit we cannot reach our purpose. And eventually our goal is to be the Unilever of good food and doing good in this world. So that's our big goal.
That's a huge goal.
That is.
That's great. Sense. Good luck.
All right, thank you. Did you know that 1 out of 7 children in the world is overweight? And did you know that 1 out of 6 children in the world is hungry? We are Lolos, and we believe kids deserve good food. And that's why we created healthy kid snacks, without any added sugar, 100% natural and organic. And for every box we sell, we give a nutritious meal to a hungry child in Africa. We are unique because we co-create with a selected group of children, our kids' board of advisors. They help us on the development of product development and promotions and branding. In January 2018, we did a crowdfunding campaign. 150 people supported us in 16 countries. Also that year, we were one of the finalists of the Albert Heijn product pitch. We sold our products in 3 big supermarkets with a rotation of 20 portion bags per week per store. We also launched in the Apenhul, a monkey zoo with over 500,000 visitors. Next year, in February, we will launch Lolos in 500 supermarkets of Albert Heijn. In May, we will start our portfolio extension with the healthy kids cereal. In 2020, we will expand our distribution with 2 extra Dutch retailers and a German retailer. And in 2020, we will start a collaboration with a big corporate to really make impact. If we look at our financials, for 2018, we will expect a revenue of 5,000 euros. For 2019, we will have a revenue of 300,000 euros, and this is mainly based on the Albert Heijn deal. For 2020, we will have a big growth to 1 million euros, and this is based on 4 retailers with 3 boxes per week per store. Today, you have the opportunity to step in for 200,000 euros and join us on this fantastic journey. We are looking for a strategic partner who has knowledge in the food market and really helps us grow this company. My name is Lisanne, and I am the CEO of Lolos. And together with co-founder Yitra, we have over 20 years of experience in the food market. Together we have 6 kids, well, not really together, but she has 4 kids and I have 2 kids. And we both lived in Africa for a couple of years. We have a strong board of advisors who advise us on topics like food, marketing, and finance. if you believe kids really deserve good food, then this is the time to make a difference. Then join Lolo's and take a bite, feed a child. Thank you.
Impressive.
Well done. Thank you.
Judges, I'm not sure if you had any time to watch the pitch, but when you're done eating, any questions? Oh, nobody. Everybody's got a full mouth.
It's snack time.
Well, maybe the proof of the pudding is I gave it to my kids after the semifinals, and they loved it. So I think that's the best thing you
can
do.
Wow. Thank you.
Well done.
Thank you so much. I'm a little bit overwhelmed, so I don't have a question right now. The kids loved it. So.
Actually, I have two questions. To become the Unilever of a competitive Unilever, or the size of Unilever, that will big steps. So you go for the first, you go to 300,000, then 1 million.
Yeah.
So what is the bigger picture in the next 5 years? Because I don't think that will be Unilever. A second, how do you finance this? Because I think this is something you ask for 200,000 euros, but usually the payment terms of these big companies, you know, are usually 60 days, 90 days. I think that will be an issue moving forward. How do you solve that?
Okay. Two questions. First one, in 5 years, we see we will have impact in Europe. We see what's happening in the UK and in Germany, and they are way ahead. If we look at the Netherlands. And we have network there, and that's why we want to start with Germany, then the UK, and then some other countries in Europe. Second is how we deal with the payment issue. We made a great deal with Albert Heijn, and I'm very proud of it because we have a payment term now of 30 days. And I'm very happy with that because that solves a bit of a cash flow issue. And we try to make great deals with other retailers, so that's a challenge. But that's how we solve that.
Yeah. Question on feeding the child in Africa. How are you going to make that happen? How's that meal getting there?
Well, great question. I'll ask Yitra to answer that.
It's a great question because it's difficult. An NGO, most of the time, not most of the time, but some of the times, the NGO tries to sell a story and the money goes pretty much elsewhere instead of the course that they're really working for. So we partnered up with a very big NGO, which already gives away 1 million meals per year. So we wanted it to be the perfect partner. So that's why we... Future Life Foundation.
And they also work with the government, and they get audited a lot. It's a German lady, and you know her from South Africa, and we are sure that it's kind of getting on the right place. What we like about the product is that it's one-on-one, so you really give a meal. It's not like 10% or 20% or whatever, it's really tangibles. So our aim eventually is to develop an app where a child can see, hey, I helped that other child in the world.
Amazing. More questions.
Yeah, I really love this. I'm curious about the other products, let's say. Do you have other products? You have other products in mind. Can you say something about it? Because, I mean, if you get the kids eating this every week, I mean, I know when I eat something every week, I get really, well, annoyed at the end, you know? Like, so I can imagine with the product life cycle, I don't know, with other tastes, what's your ambition? I'm really curious about it.
Well, our plan is to develop every half year a new product together with the kids. We already have a kids cereal ready. We tested it with the kids, and they love it again. We don't use any added sugar again. And we know it will work because Albert Heijn doesn't have it yet. They test a lot, and they're even very interested in getting it from us. So our ambition is not only these snacks, but really have a great portfolio of kids' products. And cereal is definitely the second category we're aiming for, because if you look now at the supermarkets, It's terrible. My daughter is here, and I'm not giving her any cereal because it's full of sugar. There are no fibers in it. So, well, we will see, and we are working on it to launch it even in 2019.
Awesome. Thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you. I'm curious about the deal you have with Albert Heijn.
Yeah.
Because if you need marketing to get the product out there, how much time do you get from Albert Heijn to get your marketing up and running? Can they get you out of the store in 1 month?
Or no. Well, we have a deal for 1 year, exclusive. The marketing. That's why we need. That's why I'm asking you all to fund us, because we need marketing money to convince moms about Lolos. When we look at the test we did at the three big Albert Heijn stores, Jitra and myself were there, and we were sampling like crazy, and it really works. And it's even the moms and the kids. And that's really works. The sampling in those stores. And that's why we want to use part of that money for sampling. Also, we're thinking of other campaigns, of course, not only sampling. But Albert Heijn is not asking us now to put a strong promotion in or something. But we think that we need that to convince mothers and kids to buy it.
Thank you. I actually have a question for the crowd. By show of hands, who has kids under the ages of 10?
Wow.
Hi. Hi. What do you want to know?
What are your concerns with this product? Or are you excited about it? Please share something.
I'm excited
the question.
About the product.
It's the concerns about the product and?
No, if there's any concerns.
Concerns about the product. Okay.
No, I don't have any concerns. I have kids. They don't like cereal, but that's not a problem. I think it's a good idea. It's always good to provide healthy food for kids.
And do you have any questions?
No, not really. Oh, and one maybe. Did you validate it? You said you sampled in the Albert Heijn?
Yeah.
Did you get reviews from the people who got it?
Yes, very positive. And it really works if you see a mom with a cart and a kid, and then you go there and you give them a package and the kid love it, then the mom's, okay, I will buy it. And then we tell them, well, if you buy 5 of these portion bags, so they're the small bags, you're also feeding a child in Africa. And then they buy 5.
Okay.
So that's, you know, that's what we're aiming for. And
okay, great. Okay.
Thank
There's
you.
A question behind you. Yes.
Although I appreciate people who want to help people in Africa, I have a situation I would like to put forward to you. You sell through Albert Heijn. That's your starting point.
Yeah.
I buy two at Albert Heijn. But in Holland, we have 1 million people who are under the poverty level, 1 million. Mm-hmm. That's 1 out of 17 in this country.
Yeah.
Why don't you use the revenues you get from selling through Albert Heijn to channel those to those 1 million people in Holland who have kids too? Why haven't you considered that?
Good question. I think it's because of my background, because I lived 3 years in Ghana, and I really saw the impact of not good food for children, and I really wanted to change that. And exactly the same with Yitra in South Africa, and we already had the contact in South Africa to help them. But I really love your question, because eventually we want more kids. We want a lot of kids we can help in Ghana, but also in the Netherlands, or in Kenya, or in Asia. It doesn't matter. We really want to provide good food for all of the kids. I hope that answers your question.
The cost of transportation to
Yeah, well, we are not transporting food directly from the Netherlands to Africa. The food is already in Africa, so that doesn't make a difference for us. Yeah.
Thank you very much. That will be all the questions for now.
All the questions for today. All right. All right. Well done. Give her a hand.
Thank you.
Well done. Well done.